A very good evening to all of you. Now today we are going to understand the plotting of a function which is y is equals to x square minus 10x plus 15 using the m file. We have seen some experiment in the m file, and yesterday we have seen one experiment, that is generation of sine wave using the m file. There we have used a sine function, so y is equals to sine x. It means that the y function depends on the x value. Similarly, in this case, y depends on the value of x square minus 10x and 15. Suppose if you take x as 0, then y will be equals to 15. Suppose if you take the value of x as 1, then it will be 1 minus 10 plus 15. It means that 6 value you will get. So if you change the value of x, so y value will automatically change. Now if you want to plot this function, you have to plot this function in the xy plane. So for that you require x variables and the y variables. So first you will have to generate the x variable, and depending on the x variable you will have to obtain the y variables. Now we have to create the x vector and the y vectors. So to create the x variables and the y variables, so there are three ways. The first way is v is equals to initial value is to increment is to final value. This we have already seen in the for loop. Now to understand this technique, one example is given, that is a equal to 0 is to 10 is to 100. In this case, 0 is your initial value and 100 is the final value. So you have to start your journey from 0 and you will have to reach to the 100 value. So how you are going to do? So there is the incremental step is given, that is 10. So this initial value will be incremented by 10, and again it will be incremented by 10, so and so on. So the first value is 0, the second value is 10, third value is 20, 30, 40 till 100. In the next example, there is no incrementation given. So when the incrementation is not given, and in that case the default incrementation is always 1 unit. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 up to 10 value. And the second technique is the line space. So this is the library defined function which is there in the MATLAB library. So you can directly use that line space function in your program. So line space ABN. So A means what? Initial value. B means what? Final value. And N is the incrementation. So this function will create the linearly spaced points. So you take this example, u equals to line space 0 comma 20 comma 5. So the first value is 0 and the last value is 20. So to generate the linearly spaced point, you are using this function. So 0, then 5, 10, 15 and 20. Now in the third method, that is log space, so it will create the logarithmically spaced points. That is 10 to the power 0, 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 2, 10 to the power 3 and so on. So here v equals to log space. This is also a library function which you can use directly in your code. So 0, it means what? 10 to the power 0. 3 means what? 10 to the power 3. So the first two values are initial and the final values. And 4 is the incremental. But you don't have to increment in the linear fashion. You have to increment in the logarithmic fashion. So the first will be 10 to the power 0. The second point will be 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 2, 10 to the power up to 3. You have to go. Fine. So there will be 4 points. So this 4 will indicate that you have to generate the 4 points. Similarly, in this case, 5 is given. So it means what? You have to create the 5 points. So in this way you can create the vectors in the m file. Now to start with the program, the first two functions you are quite familiar with, that is clc and clearall. And clc will clear all your command window, whereas clearall will clear all the variables which are there in the workspace. Now to generate, we have to generate the x vector. Now how you are going to generate? So we are having three techniques, that is the first one is the incremental technique, then second one is the line space, and third one is the log space. So we will be using the first technique, that is 0 is to 1 is to 10. So here 0 means what? The initial value, 1 is the incremental value and 10 is the final value. So you have to start your journey from 0 to 10 with a spacing of 1 unit. Fine. So when you enter this statement, you will get this many value, that is from 0 to 10, and they will be having a spacing of 1 unit. Now you know that y depends on the x, because x is the independent variable and y is a dependent variable. So y depends on the x. So if you put the value of x as 0, you will get y as 15. If you put the value of x as 1, which we have already discussed, you will get y as 6. Fine. But in this case, so you are having a function, that is x squared minus 10x plus 15. Now how you are going to write in the m file? So x square means what? X exponential 2 minus 10 into x plus 15. Now you can see there is a point just before the operator. Now in this case, you have to do the point to point multiplication, point to point operation, because there are 11 points, and on these 11 points you have to operate. So in that case, always you have to use a point-to-point operation. So when you are using a point-to-point operation in the M file, that time you have to place a point just before your operator. So now how many operators are there in this world? So the first one is the addition operator, then a subtraction operator, then the exponential operation, division operation, multiplication operator, and so on. So in this case, you have to place a point. So when you are placing a point, it will do the point to point operation. So first it will operate on 0 value, then it will operate on the 1 value, then 2, and so on. Fine. So after writing this y equals to x dot 2 minus 10 dot into x plus 15, you will get a y vector. So now you are having y vector and the x vector with you. So you can simply plot the curve between the xy variables. So plot x comma y. Now after plotting, you will get a figure in the figure window. Yesterday we have seen. Then you do some modification. You put an x label, y label, then title and grid on. So in this way, you can write a simple program in the M file to plot a function. Now in this way, we have completed our 4 experiment in the M file. So now it is my sincere request to all of you that please download the MATLAB mobile in from your Play Store and try executing this program in the MATLAB mobile. If you are having any problem, then please feel free to ask me at any time. So till then, goodbye.